how to understand biological anthropology. This is very important branch of anthropology, in which basically we study about two important aspect of human being, that is human biological evolution. Right? So first important aspect of biological anthropology, that is human biological evolution. And second important aspect, that is a study of human biological variation. So basic thing is that what is biological anthropology? So biological anthropology is an important branch of anthropology which deals with the study of human biological evolution and human biological variation. This is very simple understanding of biological anthropology. But here in this class, we will try to understand about a whole syllabus of biological anthropology, about UPSC Civil Services exam. Right? Here we are going to understand biological anthropology for the understanding of UPSC Civil Services syllabus related to anthropology. And when you try to understand about UPSC syllabus of anthropology, basically in first paper we found that the role of biological anthropology is very important. So here my focus is how to understand your syllabus, how to deal with our syllabus related to biological anthropology. So I already said that biological anthropology mainly deals with the study of human biological evolution and deals with the study of human biological variation. But you always remember that biological anthropology deals with the study of human evolution in biocultural perspective. Biocultural perspective. This is very important thing when you try to understand about human biological anthropology and when you try to understand about human biological evolution. Because human biological evolution, that is not only subject matter of anthropology, but it is also very important subject matter of life science, because life scientists also interested to study about human biological evolution. But anthropology is quite different from life science, right? So basically, when we are going to study human biological anthropology, we follow biocultural approach for the understanding of human biological evolution. It means when we try to study about human biological evolution, we study how biocultural factors are interrelated with each other for human biological evolution. Means when we try to study about the biological evolution of mankind, one way we try to understand about biological evolution, but we also correlate with cultural evolution. How process of cultural evolution influence to process of biological evolution of mankind. So, when we try to understand about human biological evolution on the basis of fossils remains, we have to correlate with archaeology or archaeological anthropology. Right? Because in archaeological anthropology, we try to understand about human cultural evolution from prehistory to present day. But when we try to understand about the evolution of prehistoric culture, so prehistoric culture, try to understand prehistoric culture, and here when we try to understand about human evolution in biological perspective, means when we try to study about Australopithecus, Homo habilis, Homo erectus, Neanderthal, and Homo sapiens sapiens. So basically, for the understanding of that biological evolution, we required about the knowledge of cultural evolution, because cultural factors influence to human biological evolution. So one thing you remember about in our syllabus, in first day, important topic which has started in topic number 1.4, in which first topic we have to study human evolution, in which we found that human evolution biocultural factor. So that human evolution according to biocultural factor, we are going to understand human biological evolution in biological and cultural perspective. So always remember that when we try to understand about human evolution, human biological evolution, we also give attention about the role of cultural factor which influence to human biological evolution. So here we follow biocultural perspective, not biological perspective. Our method by which we try to understand about human evolution, so we utilize both fieldwork method and laboratory method. So both fieldwork method, we are doing fieldwork for getting fossils remains, and we analyze that fossils remains in a laboratory by using traditional as well as some modern tools, because we will understand human biological evolution not only on the basis of fossils remains, but we also understand human biological evolution on the basis of genetic data. We utilize genetical method for the understanding of human evolution. So here at first you try to understand that thing clearly. For a study of human biological variation, we also utilize biocultural perspective. That is also important for the understanding of human biological variation, because the role of culture is also very important for the evolution of variation in human population. So we are going to study biological anthropology in biocultural perspective. So you can say that biological anthropology is an important branch of anthropology, deals with the study of human biological evolution and biological variation in biocultural and holistic perspective. So this is the simple definition of biological anthropology, and through that you can understand biological anthropology. So biological anthropology, in which we have to study first important thing, human biological evolution. So in which we have three important topic. First important thing is that we have to study theory of organic evolution. Theory of organic evolution. Right? Second, we have to study primatology. And third, we have to study about paleoanthropology. Right? So, if you see your syllabus, so this is mentioned in topic number 1.4. This is mentioned in topic number 1.5, and this is mentioned in topic number 1.6. So in topic number 1.4, we have to study human evolution biocultural factor. This is very important topic, and UPSC has again and again asked question on that topic. So, for the understanding of human evolution biocultural factor, we have to understand how biological factors are important for the human evolution. Another way, you have to also understand how and which cultural factors are important for the human evolution, for the understanding of human evolution. So, we have to understand human evolution in integrated perspective. Integration of biological factors and cultural factors are important for the understanding of human biological evolution. Second, when you try to approach about the study of theory of organic evolution, in which we have to study first important thing, pre-Darwinism means Lamarckism. Try to understand. Then we have to study Darwinism. Then we have to study about New Darwinism or Post-Darwinism. And then synthetic theory. Here, you try to understand these four important theories in comparative perspective, and you have to understand that theory in gradually. Means these theories are interlinked with each other. And when you try to understand this theory, you have to understand about their differences, their similarities also. Because without understanding of their differences, their similarities, you can't understand about this theory in right way. And therefore, this theory are very simple. But you try to understand that in integrated way. How? That give some base for Darwinism, or how Lamarckism was different from Darwinism. Because you try to understand that theory at first developed in 1809 and that theory developed in 1859. That theory developed in late 19th century and early 20th century, and that theory developed in middle 20th century after 1940. So for the development of synthetic theory, basically synthetic theory is a synthesis of various theory which developed before that. So you have to understand that thing in scientific way and integrated way. If you try to understand that thing in integrated way, you can easily understand about this theory. This theory are very simple. And when you try to understand this theory, you have not feel any problems, because these are very simple and you can understand that thing in very easily. Secondly, in this topic we have also learned some important terminology, and these are four important things mentioned here. That is parallelism, convergence, adaptive radiation and mosaic evolution. So you have to understand that, and that only four short notes. UPSC may be asked question, write short notes on parallelism, convergence or adaptive radiation or mosaic evolution. But these concepts give us some basic understanding of human evolution. When we try to understand about human evolution, that give us some important ideas for the understanding of human evolution. Secondly, in primatology, we have studied characteristic of primate. Basically, in which we have to study primate. And primatology is a branch of biological anthropology which deals with the study of primate evolution and evolution of primate behavior on the basis of fossils remains and observation of the social behavior of primate in their natural environment or laboratory. So basically in primatology we have to study characteristics of primate, then we have to study taxonomy, then we have to study adaptation, primate adaptation, then we have to study primate behavior, and then we have to study living primate, and then we have to study fossils related to primates. So primates, when we are going to study primate, we have to study four important members of primate, that is prosimian, monkey, ape and man. Right? So in this topic we have to study, and when you are going to study or when you are going to understand about primate, you also capable to understand about human being. So this topic is very very interesting, and in these topics we study about both thing, how primate evolved and how there was evolution of primate behavior, and how there are similarity in the behavior of human and ape, our close relatives ape, right? So there are some similarity in the social behavior of human and chimpanzee that give us also understanding about the evolution of the human social behavior at the time of prehistoric period. So that topic gave us a understanding about that. And in paleoanthropology, we study human evolution on the basis of fossils remains. Fossils remains, right? So basically in paleoanthropology, there are some important fossils which mention in our syllabus we have to study, like Australopithecine, Homo erectus, Neanderthal, Rhodesian man, Homo sapiens sapiens. These are the important fossils which are mentioned in our syllabus. But when you are going to study fossils, we have to follow some important thing, how to understand fossils remains and how to get a very good marks when we attempt about a question related to fossils, right? This is very important for us. So when you are going to study about any fossils, at first you have to understand or remember about their discovery. This is very important if we have information related which person discovered that particular fossils and where that particular fossils was discovered. This is very important for us when we trying to introduce particular fossils, and then we have to write about their geographical distribution. That is very important for us. And then we have to write about physical characteristic. And then we have to mention cultural feature also. If there is a cultural feature, then we have to write 1, 2, 3 important points related to cultural feature. And then we have to write about phylogenetic position of that fossils remains. So always remember that some students feel problem when they try to study paleoanthropology or try to understand about human fossils remains, but it is very easy topic when you will be comfortable in this topic when you follow this approach, because you have to make data or chart related to discovery. Geographical distribution you can present through world map, right? This is very important when you try to present a geographical distribution of fossils remains and you present your materials through map of world. In world map you have to show which fossils, where that fossils remains found. For physical characteristics, if you are capable to make diagram, then you will be make diagram. If you will be not capable to make diagram, then you will be write physical characteristics. And cultural characteristic, this is very simple. And for phylogenetic position, you have to make diagram. Here, diagram is also important. This is very simple because you have to remember discovery, you have to remember world map, you have to remember some physical characteristics, not more than 15. Try to understand about some students are collecting more physical characteristics than 20, 25, 30. That is not useful for us. We have to mention physical characteristics, those physical characteristics which are very important for the understanding of human evolution. So through that you can capable to understand that topic, you can capable to prepare that topic, and through that you can understand about human evolution. So second important thing related to biological anthropology, in which we study human biological variation, in which we also follow biocultural perspective. Because human is a biocultural animal, so there are development of some variation which are influenced by cultural factor. So when we are trying to study about human biological variation, we also follow biocultural perspective. Because cultural factors are also important for the development of biological variation in human population. But in our syllabus, we have to study some important thing. And if you try to look out about our syllabus, you found that In topic number 9.1, we have to study methods for a study of human genetics. A study of human genetics. Right? This is a 9.1, because from 9.1 to 12, these are the important topics which are related with human genetics or biological anthropology. So, in 9.1, we have to study some method. In 9.2, we have to study Mendelian application. Mendelian application in man. In 9.3, we have to study genetic polymorphism, and in 9.4, you have to study chromosomal disorder. Then we have to study race, variation, epidemiology, cultural anthropology, then we have to study ecological anthropology, then human growth and development, and then some concept related to reproductive biology. And then application of the knowledge of biological anthropology. But when we are going to study human genetics, first important thing is that you have to study an important topic which mentioned in topic number 1.7, in which we have to study cell, cell division, DNA, structure and function, and then mutation, then protein synthesis. That topic basically give us some basic understanding about human genetics or genetics. So that topic is important for the understanding of genetics. And so you have required basic understanding of this important term and concept. But after that, you have to study about Mendel law of inheritance. This is very important, Mendel law of inheritance. Because when you trying to study about Mendel law of inheritance, and if you develop a basic understanding about Mendel law of inheritance, so when we are going to study methods for studying human genetics, in which we have to study first important thing, pedigree analysis. So basically pedigree is a chart or diagram. And that chart or diagram made by genetist for the study of inheritance patterns of particular gene in family, man family study, right? So basically that pedigree analysis, for the understanding of that pedigree analysis, we required knowledge of Mendel law of inheritance. Here we have to apply some basic concept of Mendel law of inheritance for showing pedigree analysis. Second important thing is that in this topic we have to study twin method. We also study twin method. So, for the basic understanding of twin, we required some basic knowledge about genetics, because generally we know that there are two types of twin. First is monozygote and second is dizygote. So, when you try to understand about the genetic feature of monozygote, we found that they are copy, they are clone, because their genotype is same. Here try to understand MZ, their genotype. Genotype means genetic constitution, right? When you try to understand human genetics, you have to familiar with some important term which utilize again and again in topics which we will study. So, genotypes means genetic constitution, and phenotype means physical appearance. So, when we study about Mendel law of inheritance, we utilize that thing. So, for the understanding of MZ twin, their genotype is same. So, it will be possible their phenotype is also same. And dizygote, when we try to understand about DZ, their genotype is only 50% same, like sibling. So, their phenotype will be different, only 50% similarity. So, in that we study how genetical and environmental factors influence to variation, influence to development of variation, genetic variation or physical variation in twin, and through that we can capable to understand about some important concept of genetic human genetics. So this is important for us. And then we have also study in this topic, an important topic mentioned in this topic. There are three important terms utilized in our syllabus, that is cytogenetics. Cytogenetics is the study of cell. And chromosomal analysis and karyotyping. So basically karyotyping is method by which we get karyotype of an individual, and karyotype of an individual give us information about a structural and numerical disorder of particular person at a chromosome level. So basically cytogenetics, chromosomal analysis and karyotyping, these three important terms you have to study together, and through that integration of these three important terms you can capable to understand about importance of that method. Then we have to study biochemical method. So in biochemical method basically we study about some important role of biochemical factor in human genetics, because enzymes and hormones, the role of hormone, the role of enzyme. So by the application of the knowledge of biochemistry, we are capable to analyze about some inborn error of metabolism, which is the product of enzyme deficiency or error in enzyme, that we will study in biochemical genetics. Then immunological method, in immunological method we study about some disorder which related to immune system, and then we have to recombinant DNA technology is very very important for the understanding of human genetics, and it is also important for our practical purpose. So this important topic we have to study for short notes. Basically, generally UPSC asks question on that topic for short notes. But when you are going to a study about human genetics and this topic, try to understand term clearly. You have to develop clear concept on particular term. And if you have developed a concept, a very clear cut concept on particular term, then you can easily understand about that. In 9.2, we have to study about a application of Mendel law of inheritance in man. So basically in that, one term mentioned single factor, right? Right term for that is monogenetic, means monogenetic character, inheritance of monogenetic character in human being, and that monogenetic character which follow Mendelian law of inheritance. So there are many human gene which follow Mendelian law of inheritance. So for the understanding of that, we have to give examples from human gene, and basically we know that gene situated on the locus of chromosome and gene inherited in next generation through chromosome. So for the understanding of that topic, we have to understand some important disease which occur due to single gene and their inheritance pattern. So here we have to study autosomal chromosomal inheritance in man, and in autosomal we have to also study dominant autosomal, recessive autosomal, then we have to study X chromosome dominant, then we have to study X chromosome recessive, and then we have to study Y chromosome. And through that example you can understand. After that, there is a topic mentioned that is polygenic, multifactor, lethal and sublethal, right? So polygenic, try to understand that concept. Polygenic means there are some character in human being which are determined by more than one gene. That character is known as a polygenic. Polygenic inheritance is a exception of Mendel law of inheritance. That is exception of Mendel law of inheritance. So we have to study that polygenic inheritance means inheritance of our skin color. Skin color determined by many gene. Our face is also determined by many gene. Our height, our weight, there are many characters in human being which are polygenic. Then multifactor, when we try to understand about Mendel law of inheritance, Mendel had only given focus to role of genotype. He had not given focus to role of environmental factor for the occurrence of phenotypic feature in a pea plant. But after that, when there was development of genetics, many genetists found that for phenotypic expression of any trait, the role of genetic factor and environmental factor both are important, and therefore that known as a multifactor. Lethal gene is a kind of gene by which if any person influenced that not survive, that suffering from lethal disease and that become dead in early childhood. After that, we have to study about genetic polymorphism. So here try to understand about polymorphism and polygenic, right? In polygenic, we are talking at the level of genotype. Try to understand. Means we can understand about variation at a gene level. Here we understand variation at a physical appearance. General, try to understand. So polymorphic means if any Mendelian trait found in population more than two morph, and that found 1% in population, that is called polymorphic, genetic polymorphism. So there are many polymorphic traits available in human being. That is first important thing is that we have to study. ABO blood group is an important example of genetic polymorphism. Then we have to study about HLA, sickle cell hemoglobin, lactose deficiency, etc. So in this we have to study that thing. We also study in this topic Hardy-Weinberg law. Hardy-Weinberg were two important scientists who had given an important theory of population genetics, which is known as a Hardy-Weinberg law. This is very simple. And after that, we have to study change in gene frequency. So factor responsible for change in gene frequency. This is very similar to when we study about human biological evolution. And when we study about synthetic theory, you found also these factors mentioned in that. So you can easily understand that thing. And when you try to understand about chromosomal disorder, that is a very factual topic. But a basic understanding about, if you have basic understanding about chromosome, so there are two types of chromosome, autosomal or sex. So when we try to understand about disorder, we have to also understand autosomal disorder and sex chromosome disorder. And race is also, that is a static topic that you can easily understand, that is factual. And you can understand that in very simple way. And in 9.6, that is also related with race, because in that day we study about some important genetic marker by which we can understand about variation. As for example, then epidemiological anthropology, that is very important topic which mentioned in our syllabus, that deals with the study of speed of disease in human population in bio-cultural environmental perspective. So this year it is very important, in which we have to study about concept of health and disease. So concept of health and disease vary from society to society. Here for the study of epidemic disease or pandemic disease, we have follow bio-cultural approach, not follow biomedical approach. So different society has different concept regarding health and disease, and therefore when we are going to study epidemiological anthropology, we have to study epidemiological anthropology on the basis of some important case study. And in we also study infectious disease, non-infectious disease, and nutritional related disease. And after that, one topic that belongs from ecological anthropology, that is related with ecology also, but in ecological anthropology we study about interrelations between man and their environment in biocultural perspective or holistic perspective. In topic number 10, we study human growth and development, that is also a factual topic. And in topic number 11, we study some important concept related to reproductive biology, as for example menarche and menopause, etc. And lastly, in topic number 12, we have to study about application of the knowledge of biological anthropology for the betterment of human being, in which we have studied some important thing like anthropology of sports, nutritional anthropology, forensic anthropology, application of the knowledge in designing defense and other equipment, eugenics, and we also study about genetic counseling for eugenics, and application of the knowledge of biological anthropology in reproductive biology. So these are important topics which mention in our syllabus that related to biological anthropology, and through that you can understand about biological anthropology. So this is biological anthropology.